To be a Python coder, we need to solve problems. In this video, we look at the problem of creating a Rummy card game. Stay tuned to see the complete and final solution in how to solve a problem, Python coder. And improve your Python coding. How can you improve? Well, you can learn from a trusted source, someone that teaches every day with decades of experience, teaches students from around the world at the highest level of teaching. So if you're interested in learning Python, please subscribe. Now let's move on to the problem. We wanted to code a simple game of Rummy, but it has been not that simple. It's been quite difficult. So we can go through the design, break it down to before the game and playing the game. So before the game, we shuffle a pack, we deal the hands, and there's one spare card we call the flop card. Play the game, we have two players. The first player is the user, the second player is the computer. First, we started off with a simple game with just the numbers and the face cards. But then we made it more complex by adding suits, which is how the proper game is played. Recognize a winning hand was the first big problem that we encountered. Then we moved on to the player options, then adding the computer player, and then moving from the simple game to the complex game, we looked at how to add suits and colors, and then added them in the last video. So now we want to complete all of the game and all of the code. So let's see how we set up before the game. Let's start changing our design into actual code. So here we have our comments about how we set the game up. And now if we look at the code, we're going to get the cards. So that's going to be a shuffle pack. We create the hands. We remove those hands from the pack, we get the flop card, and then when we have the hand, we'll show it to the player so we can show the full hand. So if we look at our code previously from the video part 4, we had how to show suits and colors and how we calculated the suit, and previously we had the printed card, convert card, and get cards functions. These functions were described in detail in the video marked part 2. Now let's look at the code when we're playing the game. So we have loop, and then we have the flop card, and we show the hand to the player the same we did before. And then we need to check to see if it's a winning hand. So we can create a variable end. If it's 0, we continue. Created the 0 before, and then if it's 1, then we say the game is ended. So we need to create a function to check to see if we have a winning hand. That's what we'll look at now. In video 1, was using numbers 2 to 14 to represent the numbers 2 to 10, Jack, Queen, King, Ace. But now when using the numbers 1 to 52, we change the code to check to see if it's a winning hand to deal with that. Now the changes wasn't that much, it's basically just adding the convert card function to the check to see if we have 3 of a kind or 4 of a kind. So that code hasn't changed that much. The check run is the same because we're looking for consecutive cards. Now we found that the code was a bit buggy, so you can see if we just go to the bottom here, we found some difficult hands to check to see if they're winning hands. So we've got like a run of 2, 3, 4, 5, but we've also got 3 2s. Now that's very difficult to check to see that actually that's not a winning hand. So we found these difficult hands, we put them in a list, and then we checked the code. We decided to change the design, but to keep the code like we did before, so code reuse but not duplicated. So we have check the same and check run before, But what we do is we check to see if there's four of a kind first and remove them from a temporary list, and then check the remaining cards for either three of a kind or three which is in a run. We can pan out to show you all the code from the top. Check same, check run, check end to see if we've finished. So we do the check same, check run, see if there's four of a kind. If there is, remove them and then check for three of a kind or three of a run from the remaining three cards. So that's how we check to see if a hand is the end of the game. So now in our code we only need to act the get player option and the get computer options. The code for the player options is quite complex because we had to do quite a lot of debugging. So let's just put a general outline of the code in first. So we get the player options. They have the cards, the pack, the hand and the flop card. So the player chooses to keep the flop card. If they do, we have to remove another card from the hand. If they don't want the flop card, they get a new card and then they're offered if they want to keep that or not. If they don't, that becomes the new flop card, and if they do, we again have to ask the user which card they want removed to their hand. So we have another function called remove card, which the user chooses which card to remove. Now they might have the same card, the same number, say two jacks or two twos, and we want to know which suit they want to remove. So again we have another function called remove F card where they say which suit it is. So this is an outline of the player options. So now let's move on to the computer options. The computer is similar to the player in that it gets the flop card and either keeps it or gets a new card and then returns the flop card and the hand. So that's similar to the player, but also we need to code how the computer determines if to keep a card, what card to remove if it does. In the third video we created the code for the computer to play the game. This was based on the idea of checking for the best hand, the four of a kind or four of a run, and then looking at the remaining cards using the same function we call check for best. So if we look at the code, we've changed the code to deal with the numbers 1 to 52 rather than the simple 2 to 14. And that involves using the convert card in the code. So we do that for 3 and 4 of a kind. And also we deal with when a number is in the hand, such as a 2, we look at each version of the spade, the heart, club and a diamond. So we do that with all of the code. You can see we've changed it here. And that code is the same except for those changes that we do to deal with each number in each suit. So essentially the same card, the same code. We check for best for four for three of a kind first and then the second remaining cards. We use the same code. Now let's go through the game and the code in detail. We have the setting up of the shuffle pack and dealing the cards the same as before. Now let's play the game. So we're going to check to make sure the game finishes. So if the cards run out, there's no winner. We get the flop card. We're going to print the hand to the player. This code here is to make sure it's colored black. So we've got the player options that we'll look at in detail in a minute. We check to see if it's a winning hand. And then we do the same with the computer. Check to see if there's cards left, flop card, print the hand to the computer to test it. In the game, obviously, we wouldn't see the computer's hand. Then the computer options, so we've seen them. And then check to see if it's a winning hand again. So that's the game. Now we just need to look at the player options in detail. So let's move up to the player options. we can see here the player options that we had before, and now we're just going to change that code to the full code. So now we have the get player options. So we ask the user if they want to keep the flop card. If they do, we put that in the hand, and then we have to remove a card, or the user has to choose which card to remove. If they don't want the flop card, then they get a new card from the pack. So we pop that from the pack, show that to the user. Now, do they want to keep the new card? If they don't, that becomes the new flop card given to the computer. If they do, we add it to the hand, and then again we ask the user which card they wish to remove. Now, the remove card function, we can look at this. We show the user the hand, then we ask them which card they want to remove from their hand. We check to see if it's a Jack, Queen, King, Ace, because we need to change that to a number. And then we change the card to a spade, heart, club or diamond to see if it's in the hand or not. Now, if it's in the hand once, we can remove it quite easily. But what happens if it's in the hand twice? So if a user has two threes and they want to remove a three of spades, they've also got a three of diamonds. We need the user to be able to tell us which card they want to remove. So we've got this function called remove F card. And then after they've removed the hand, the user can then see the hand afterwards. So let's have a look at remove F card. So if a user's got more than one of a card in their hand, so two twos or three threes for example, we ask the user which one they want to remove. Jack, for example, so spades, hearts, clubs or diamonds. So they can enter S, H, C or D, and then if they enter an S, then we remove the spade, a H, a heart, C, a club, a D and a diamond. So that way the user can remove the suit of the card, or they can tell the program which suit of the card they want to remove. Let's run the program, play the game. We've got 10 of hearts, let's keep that, put in K. Right, so we've got 10, what do we want to get rid of? We've got two queens, we've got two sixes, this 9, might be the 5, we don't need the 5. Okay, we've got the ace, do we want to keep it? Not really. An 8 doesn't help us. A 2 spades, no. 3 of clubs, no. You can see the computer hasn't got much of a good hand either. So 6, let's keep 6. So we've got 3 sixes. So what do we want to keep? 2 queens, 2 nines, perhaps. Should we go for the hearts? So let's get rid of the 9. And now which 9? We've got a 9 of heart, a 9 of spade, and we want to get rid of the spade. So now we've got rid of the spade. It's given us a 10 of spade. So let's say we don't want the 10 of spade or the jack of diamonds. 2 of hearts, no. King, no. Ace, no. Queen, yes, we want to keep the queen. So we've got 3 queens now. Let's take out the 10. Let's see if we can go for, we've got 3 sixes and 3 queens now. Ace, no. 3, no. 4, no. 5, no. King, no. Ace, no. 2, no. Queen, yes. So we want to get rid of the 9. And hopefully that will be the winner. Yes, it is. We won the game. So the computer was one card away as well. Wow, that was a good game. Because there's so many different types of hands to check, we're constantly debugging. So here we can see we had 3 sixes and 4 queens. And because the 3 sixes were first, we had a break in the code that meant that we didn't see the four of a kind when we checked to see if it was a winning hand. So we're constantly looking to improve the code with, in this case, there are so many different types of hands, you have to just keep playing and debug when you find any errors. We have a winning hand here, so we keep the 10, we get rid of the 7, and now we check to see that we have the 4 kings and the 3 twos. Let's have a final look at the code. We had get cards, we get the shuffle pack, convert that to 2 to 10 in the faces, the jack, queen, king, ace, which we can print, calculated to suits. We have the colours, red and blue, and then we can print them when we print the hand. We also use them when you show one card, either the flop or a new card. We ask the user which suit they want to remove, if there's more of a card, like two twos in the hand, so they choose which suit they want to remove. In a remove card, the user chooses which card to remove, and then we also remove if there's more than one of that one, as we've seen before. The get player options, the player chooses either to keep or not to keep the flop card, to keep or not keep the new card, and remove a card if they've kept one of them too. The same with the computer. And the final code, the beginning of the game, we create the cards, the shuffle pack, deal the two hands, remove those hands from the pack. In a loop, we check to see if there's remaining cards, we do the player options, check to see if it's a winning hand. And again, the same with the computer, check to see if there's any cards, show the flop, show the hand, get the computer options, and then check to see if it's a winner at the end. Well, thank you for watching, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. If you like the video, please like and share on your social media. Don't forget to click the bell for notifications if you're interested in learning Python, to keep up to date with the new videos.